Jim Hall is the most innovative designer in the history of American racing, and he was a top driver, a combination which puts him in a class by himself.
I was the team development engineer, and I was the driver, and I'd say that communication between the two was quite good. And that's an important part, and that's what I wanted to mention. I think communication and what you tell the engineer is a really important part of your job. He has to try to use the information that you give him to make the car act like you'd like it to act. And the more you can tell him, the better detail, and not give him information that you're not very sure of, and you want to at least make sure that he understands you're not very sure of it, because he might make a change based on it. So your communication with the engineer on your team is a really important part of your job. I've also worked with drivers as an engineer, and it becomes more difficult when you are the driver and the engineer. I know sometimes I've thought, God, if I could just get in and see what he feels, I would if I could feel that, I could probably do better. So I thought it was probably an advantage for me to be the driver, the designer, and the development engineer. But I've had people tell me that they thought that maybe was a negative for me, because I wasn't able to specialize enough as a driver, or specialize enough as an engineer. I think I feel comfortable that for me it was a good thing, not a bad thing. Well, it's all of course the whole setup and the way the car runs is all based on physical principles, and they do. It's hard to do anything that's magic. It all has to be based on fact.
It was very much in character that many of his designs focused on something invisible, air. Drawing on his experience building model airplanes, Jim understood air as a palpable substance, its movement over a car to be exploited in an endless variety of ways.
I got involved in the aerodynamic development of race cars early, and I had some things that I needed to do, and I guess I really put it down on a piece of paper and thought about it, and realized how important it was to understand the vertical aerodynamic forces on a car and what you could do with them, and probably had a little better understanding early in that game than other people that were working with it. And it was maybe because I was the driver, and so I did feel it. So I had a pretty close relationship with how that car felt and how it reacted to those forces. And it allowed Chaparral and myself to have a career that spanned several years, where we were able to work with the aerodynamics of the race car and provide a car that had more performance and a better feel to the driver. When we first brought the high wing car to Bridgehampton and showed it, I had one of the prominent designers state that, that's a crutch. If Hall had the suspension right, he wouldn't need that. But I think he learned fairly quickly that that wasn't the case. And it is a little surprising how long some of the people and designers took to understand that was one of the things of the future, that the car was not only a ground vehicle, it was an air ground vehicle, and you had to look at the combination of the two. It's not rocket science. It's something that anybody really wants to spend some time and think about it. I think we can show you how you can understand and help you perfect the setup on your car. I like the statement, safe is fast, and we really paid attention to that in our cars. Number one, you don't want to get hurt in it. So that's not the number one thing you're interested in. Number two, you want to finish the race, because you can't win if you don't finish. And number three, you can work on how fast you get it. So you want to keep it in that order all the time. Safety, reliability, and then go for the speed.